Hi everyone, TylerSky123 here, back doing another Doctor Who classic review, this time taking a look at Full Circle, the four-part story and the start of the E-Space trilogy. You know, it's the first story in that trilogy, you know, that little bubble towards the end of the Fourth Doctor's run. After the trilogy is over, there's only the Keeper of Draken and Logopolis left for him. And, you know, it's kind of like an interesting choice, I guess, but it works as it's right in the middle of the 18th season. And, you know, it's a bit like The Key to Time in a way, but less extensive, less strenuous, I feel. And, you know, it works quite well, I think. Had it been any longer, it might not have worked too well, but E-Space Trilogy as a whole works for me. And, you know, starting it off with Full Circle, which is, you know, a very good story, I feel. Very strong story. So let's start off with Matthew Waterhouse as Adric. He gets a lot of hate, I feel. You know, a lot of unnecessary hate. And a lot of people don't like Adric at all. They don't like the character. They say Matthew Waterhouse's acting is dreadful. I personally like it, you know. However, well, his voice acting is fine. I think he does his voice very well for the most part. However, there are times like, when they're all in the Outlaw's Cave, his first scene, I think it is, with Varsh and whatnot, they're all doing something, whereas he is just standing there next to Varsh doing nothing, as if he's waiting for his line. That's unfortunate, I'm afraid. That didn't work for me. You know, he just feels too static in that scene, and there are quite a few other scenes where he feels too static. But, you know, other than that, he's okay. He's not terrible by any means. He's not as bad as a lot of people make him out to be. And, you know, as I say about the voice being, that goes back to Big Finish, who he recently started doing stories for, you know, the Fifth Doctor box set and whatnot. And, you know, that translates over perfectly because his voice is great and, you know, he doesn't have to worry about his body acting and whatnot. It's just the voice that matters. And, you know, while it's not amazing at the start of Psychodrome, you know, he's getting back into the character and whatnot. By the time you get into that story and then move on to Iterations Y, he's fine, you know. Matthew Waterhouse was great in the Fifth Doctor box set, but anyway, that's not what we're talking about here. We're talking about Full Circle. And then, you know, Tom Baker. What a performance he gives, you know. He often gets criticised by quite a few people, myself included in a way, you know, towards the end of his era and whatnot, you know, in the latter half, being a bit too silly, a bit too comedic, not taking it seriously enough. And, you know, I'm fine with him doing that from time to time, but I do like to have that element of seriousness as well, like he has in stories of, like, Seeds of Doom and whatnot. Maybe Seeds of Doom is a bit too extreme an example, because that's kind of like on the other side of the scale. I prefer to have the balance, but this story gets the balance, you know. And he's very serious when he's talking to the deciders and that scientist character whose name I've forgotten. You know, he gives some very powerful dialogue, and you know, he gives a very powerful performance in those scenes, and kind of like his sympathy for the master creatures as well, especially that child master creature, was very well displayed, I feel. And yet, this is probably his strongest performance at the end of his era, I guess. You know, it's one of his strongest performances towards the end. I don't think he gives a performance this strong after it, but you know, he does come close. You know, he starts to pick up seriousness again. But this story, Tom Baker is on point, he really is. Then, Lala Ward of Romana. Romana's kind of relegated in this story. You know, she doesn't get to do all that much, I'm afraid. But, you know, that's fine, because that helps to establish the character of Adric, who goes on to become a companion. But, you know, it's mainly the Fourth Doctor and Adric, whereas Romana's left out a bit. Which, you know, is fine, because that's made up for in the next story, where it's mainly the Fourth Doctor and Romana, whereas Adric sits out for a bit. More on that next, not next time, whenever I review States Decay, which is coming up pretty soon, you know. I'm spacing out these E-Space Trilogy reviews. And, also, finally, we have K-9, who, you know, plays an okay role in this. His head does get knocked off, but you know, at the start of the story, he's doing all right. Yeah, he has his own little adventure bit where he's following the Marshmen, but you know, overall, K9's not too good, not got the best stuff to do in this. You know, that's mainly because of the limitations of the prop itself. But anyway, you know, Tom Baker and Matthew Waterhouse, they're the main focus of the story, I guess, and they do carry it rather well, I feel. So yeah, that's a positive there. Now, going on to the marsh creatures themselves. In fact, no, let's talk about the world itself, the world of Alzarius, the ecology of Alzarius and whatnot. It's very well built up, I'd say, in terms of narrative and visuals as well. You feel very drawn into this world. The location footage, which must have been done in the UK, because the first overseas shoot was Amsterdam for Ark of Infinity. You know, here, it very much feels tropical in a lot of senses, and yet it's filmed in summer, and that really does come across, and that really does go in this story's favour, I feel. You know, scheduling helps it there, and very much gives it this lush feel, it really does, I feel. And I'm not sure whether they did something to the camera, I don't know, but it just does feel alien, and, well, yeah, it feels different from anything else that Doctor Who has done before, which is strong, that's a positive. And then, of course, the marsh, actually, no, I keep holding up on the Marshmen, but yeah, I'm going back to the narrative telling of this world. You know, there are lots of revelations in the final part and whatnot, and I feel that's carried out very well. So now, the Marshmen themselves, finally, the Marshmen, you know, they and Alzarius and kind of like all this stuff is reappearing in Mistfall this month, actually, because they're releasing it this month. It's a sequel to the story, and it features the Fifth Doctor, and it's the first part of a new E-Space trilogy, a second E-Space trilogy. Looking forward to that. I have got that as part of a subscription, so I'll be reviewing all of them and more at a later date. But anyway, right now, full circle, and the Marshmen in this, they feel like a credible threat, and they are memorable. However, in fact, they're probably the most memorable monsters of Tom Baker's final season, I would say. But anyway, you know, going back to them in terms of story, they are a little underdeveloped. But, you know, it could be much worse for them. And obviously, there's a sequel coming up which will probably develop them more. And, you know, there are a lot of twists and whatnot with the characters themselves, which can be a bit... the story itself, which can get a bit confusing, kind of like revelations that do come along a bit too fast, unfortunately. But, you know, that doesn't really bother me too much, you know. I mean, we've got DVDs now, we could go back and watch the story again and learn to understand it a bit more. And, you know, it's nice to have a story that isn't simple and straightforward for once. And, you know, of course, I have to mention that Andrew Smith, I think it is, the writer of this, who's also writing this book, was only 17 or 18, I can't remember which, but he was very young at the time of writing this, and, you know, it doesn't come across at all, it feels very professional. You know, I think it's just amazing how young he was, yet how well he did with his story. He was definitely a very strong scriptwriter. So, it's a shame he didn't go on to write for more, but what he did write with Full Circle was great, and of course he's done some big finishes now that he's older and whatnot. So yeah, I think that's all I've got to say about Full Circle. Almost called it Mistfall then. But yeah, Full Circle is a very good story, I feel. And you know, if you want to get the E-Space trilogy as a box set, I highly recommend you do. It's a great trilogy. And you know, this is a great first part to that. So thanks for watching, everyone, and I'll see you all next time with a review of The Death of Hope, part of Dark Eyes 3. Bye, everyone. Yeah.